Hi friends, today I am going to discuss about pheochromocytoma, which is the most common tumor of adrenal medulla in adults. Adrenal medulla, adrenal gland. We have adrenal gland on the top of each kidney. This is adrenal medulla, the blue one. And the outer part is called cortex and the inner part is adrenal medulla. In medulla, there will be some chromaffin cells which are derived from the neural crest of sympathetic nervous system from these chromaffin cells. It can also present extra-adrenally in areas like para-aortic areas between the diaphragm and lower renal poles and the organ of Zuckerland. These are the common extra-adrenal sites of pheochromocytoma. Coming to pheochrom, as I already said, it occurs in adrenal gland as well as extra adrenal also. 90% of the tumors are adrenal and 10% of tumors will be extra adrenal. The adrenal pheochromocytoma secretes epinephrine mainly, whereas the extra adrenal pheochromocytoma secretes norepinephrine. Rule of 10 is applicable to pheochromocytoma, that is, 10% of these tumors are malignant, 10% are bilateral, 10% are extra adrenal, 10% present in children, and 10% of these diseases is not associated with hypertension. That is, the hypertension is present in approximately 90% of these patients. Coming to the clinical features. Clinical features are can be remembered with the help of 5P. They present in sudden episodic or paroxysmal events. Episodic events, spells of hyperadrenergic symptoms. These are pressure, that is increased BP. Hypertension will be present. Headache will be present. Sweating will be present, that is called perspiration. Palpitations, that is tachycardia, will be present. And pallor is also present in these patients. Heart will be beating very fast due to the catecholamine excess released by the tumor. And catecholamine excess is the main reason for all these clinical features of this disease. This tumor secretes dopamine, adrenaline, that is epinephrine and norepinephrine, adrenaline and noradrenaline. And this results in the metabolism of these catecholamines. For example, urine VMA will be very more in these patients. Serum and urine levels will be high. Serum catecholamine levels and urine VMA levels will be very high. Latestly, serum chromogranin A is elevated in about 90% of these patients. VMA is vinylyl mandelic acid, and this pheochromocytoma is associated with neurofibromatosis 1, VHL, 1 Hippel-Lindau syndrome, and MEN2, multiple endocrine neoplasia 2 and 3, and these are all associated with pheochromocytoma. As I already said, urine vinylyl mandelic acid levels will be more, serum catecholamine levels will be increased. And coming to the next step of investigations, those are MRI and CT. MRI is more preferred than CT. In this, Swiss cheese pattern can be seen. And the important thing here is iodine-123 MIBG scan, that is meta-iodobenzylgonadine. This scan is very important in this patient. In a patient with urine VMA positive, serum catecholamine levels positive, and whereas MRI is negative, iodine-123 MIBG scan will help you in diagnosing this condition. Coming to the treatment, surgery is the treatment of choice. But our aim is to decrease the high BP. Generally, catecholamines act on alpha receptors, which results in vasoconstriction, that is increasing the blood pressure of the patient. So we have to give alpha blockers. Alpha blockers have to be given to reduce the BP, that is blood pressure. For example, phenoxybenzamine and phentolamine will be given. And as a result, tachycardia may be seen in this patient, which is to be prevented by beta blockers, for example, propranolol. Increased BP should be decreased by alpha blockers. Later, beta blockers have to be given to decrease the tachycardia and to control BP. Later on, we have to proceed for surgery. This is to control blood pressure intraoperatively. IV phentolamine can be used. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to my channel if you like the video. Have a nice day.